In the chase that followed, a giant porcupine stuck 50 sharp quills into the boar, and a chimpanzee in a tree threw a coconut at the porcupine that jammed its head into its body. All this was against the laws of the forest, and when the excitement was over, Gugu the Leopard King called his royal counselors together to decide how best to punish the offenders. The four lords of the forest were holding solemn council in a small clearing when they saw two strange beasts approaching them, beasts the like of which they had never seen before. Not one of the four, however, relaxed his dignity or showed by a movement that he was startled. The great leopard crouched at full length upon a fallen tree trunk. Bru the bear sat on his haunches before the king. Rango the gray ape stood with his muscular arms folded, and Lu the unicorn reclined, much as a horse does, between his fellow counselors. With one consent they remained silent, eyeing with steadfast looks the intruders, who were making their way into their forest domain. "Well met, brothers," said one of the strange beasts, coming to a halt beside the group, while his comrade with hesitation lagged behind. "We are not brothers," returned the gray ape sternly. "Who are you, and how came you to the forest of Gugu?" "We are two Limon-Eags," said Ruggedo, inventing the name. "Our home is in the Sky Island, and we have come to earth to warn the forest beasts that the people of Oz are about to make war upon them and enslave them, so that they will become beasts of burden forever after, and obey only the will of their two-legged masters."